WKTV, your station for sports in the tri-state, presents The Sonny Randle Show with Marshall University head football coach Sonny Randle. Today's program brought to you in part by Ashland Oil, where Ashland people do a good job and a little more. Now your host, Channel 13 sports director Terry Bumgarner.
Hi, everybody, and welcome once again to the Sonny Randle Show. What a ball game yesterday. Marshall wins it 56-7. I don't really know where to begin on that. 56-7, an unbelievable way to finish out the season.
Well, it was a great way to end the season, Terry. It really was. Only fitting, I think. I shared with the youngsters before the game. I said, I want two things. I want you to play like everybody knows you're capable of playing, and I want you to show everybody just how good you really are, and I want you to win it for yourselves. And they went out and did just that. They really did, and the thing that I guess will stay with me forever is that group of seniors, there's 10 of them, and we'll meet them and see them later on in the show. But they go out winners, and they go out the group that turned the program around. So they'll be remembered forever, and what a way to go out.
Pretty emotional moment for you when they introduced the 10 of them before the game, wasn't it?
Well, it always is. You know, it's amazing how close you get, and I think that that separates the collegiate world from the professional world. That's the reason I'd never want to go back to pro football. That's a business. It's not a business in college. You get real, real close. You know, you laugh together. You get very emotional together. You know, it's a life, and every day it's something different. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. But as I say, there are enjoyable times and there are sad times, and there are times that just eat your heart out. And one of those days rolled around yesterday when we had to say goodbye, but we'll never say goodbye. It was just that final ball game.
You know, it's no big secret. It was the talk all around town that your job status was questionable before the ball game. What's the situation now?
Well, I don't really know, Terry, to be honest with you. I haven't met with Dr. Snyder or Dr. Clagg yet. I'm sure we'll do that real, real soon. And I guess they'll nail thing down at that time. I'd give anything in the world, certainly, to be a part of it. I think we've made unbelievable progress. We've got 17 stars returning next year and on the verge of, having exactly what everybody's wanted here for a long, long time. And, as I say, yeah, certainly you'd love to be a part of it. And, you know, we hope things will fall into place. Our guys, our staff, and the kids, they've worked their families off, and we've done a great job thus far recruiting. You know, our kids, they've responded, and you know, they want very much to, have us as a part of their family. And we got things just where we want them right now. So we'll wait and see and hope for the best and hope and pray things, go the way most people want them to.
You know, I would think that the speculation might have made it kind of hard to prepare for the game, and yet the kids went out and won it so big. Might they have won that one for you, you think, or is that fair to put that on?
No, I don't really think so. I wouldn't want to put that on them. In my coaching career, I've never asked youngsters to go play it for me. They play it for themselves. That one was played for them. And as I say, they showed how good they really were, regardless of, what might happen to me. It's a great group of kids and a real fine institution. And, I'd certainly wish them the very best. I'd love, to be able to pull a trigger, but I'm not going to be able to make that decision.
Okay, well, anybody who has suffered through losing seasons at Marshall before, sit back and enjoy this one. It's going to be a truckload of Marshall highlights when we come back after this. Final score once again yesterday, Marshall 56 and VMI 7. Who would have guessed earlier in the year that Marshall would roll up 56 points against anybody? Absolutely perfect day for football at Fairfield Stadium, and there they are, the seniors.
That's the group that made it all possible, Terry. As I say, we'll meet them and hear from them later on, but boy, what a super group of young men.
You have to kick off to start off the ball game. Scott Latula probably had his leg worn out by the end of the day.
I'll tell you what, he did a great job yesterday. He's done a great job all year long. He is a real fine freshman running back, Bridges. And I'll tell you one thing, he might have rushed for over 100 yards five games in a row, but our people on defense were determined that he wasn't going to romp and stomp yesterday afternoon.
Defense really responded on the very first series, and that kind of set the tone for the game. Short punt, gives you good field position. I like this call to start the game.
A reverse, and, you know, those people are cranked up. A great call, and they're always great when you, you know, get big yardage. Swisher takes it, and we just, we thought that they'd look for Queen right out of the box. Here we have a little mistake that keeps us from getting the first down.
But here comes really the first big play of the ball game. Glenn Bates makes it.
Well, when you find a football, you're going to find shake around the ball. He comes up with a big interception. He's just disappointed he didn't score.
He played a great game for his last game, didn't he?
He really did. They boot out of there, and quarterback sets the throw and shakes right there where he's supposed to be. Picks it off, and he'll make things happen here. I never dreamed one guy like that would make a tackle in the open field.
And he almost broke a punt return later on. We'll see that. But here you go. Got the great field position and did something with it.
Right, four clean runs hard on the power. Big boys up front, the Hogs, they were doing the job. Your opponent takes it real close and gets in there.
And another example of a senior who really really had a good game
had
for
a
his last
year
one.
Year and has had a great, great career. You can see him turn up inside. He smells the end zone. I didn't know whether he got in or not, but when that fella surrendered down there in the end zone, I knew he got in there.
7-0 at that point. Defense comes out. Eugene almost picked one off.
Remus had a big, big day yesterday. All they had to do is look that one in. That would have been him.
I see you were telling him how to catch the ball
there. Yeah, it was a little too late to tell him now. He ran the spin draw, and Queen runs up in there for excellent yardage.
And once again, you started with great field position on this drive and again took advantage of it.
Call folded. Boy, that was just a... That was very, very close to being a big, big play. Joe Willie threw the ball very, very well yesterday.
Big he play here. Could have been an interception. It wasn't.
It goes the other way, and you know, we're in business. So fourth corner makes a real, real fine catch.
You know,
Queen Bee.
Something you and I talked about a minute ago before we went on. It's amazing how the breaks go your way when you're playing well.
Well, you make your own breaks here, Terry, and we made ours yesterday. Here we run the toss sweep down the goal line. And Queen, he gets in again.
14-0, first quarter. The route is about to be on, but at this point, it's still in doubt.
Well, you know, at no time can you let up, that's for sure. Here we run a toss sweep. Queen, he's right back down there again.
And you see it again, 14-0 at that point. Defense comes back out on the field. Defense does it again. Sack the quarterback twice in a row here.
He certainly played on both sides of the ball yesterday. With a lot of emotion and a lot of enthusiasm. And I'll tell you one thing, it made a big, big difference.
And here's Carl Fodor going to complete one to Todd Evans.
Right on the money.
And a big nice run.
Senior, he makes it happen. He had a great ball game yesterday. I was very, very happy for him.
He was leaning for the goal line, I'll tell you.
He sure was.
And we're now into the second quarter, same series. And watch four Queen get flipped here.
Oh, my. But you know what? Queen gets up. The guy that flipped him doesn't.
That's right. We'll see it again here on the replay. And were it not for that one man, he would have scored on
yes,
the play.
Yes, sir, he sure would have.
That got it down close, and Cassiopo takes it over for the touchdown.
Cass had a big, big day yesterday at fullback, he and Don Johnson both. Red games, Don Johnson, they want them. He sure has come to play.
I'll tell you what, everybody, I can't think of anybody that didn't play an exceptionally good game.
Oh, sure, yeah. Boy, here you can see him. They went to turn loose yesterday. Look at the green jerseys.
And take a look at this. We talked about Glenn Bates and how he almost broke it. Watch the punt return.
Shake wanted this one. He really did.
Nice move to get past that guy. And I'm really surprised he got caught here.
Well, I don't know what happened to him there. But Shake, you can see, he's got all the moves in the world.
And here he freezes the guy and
you
goes see right around.
Call him Shake right
yeah.
there.
he puts on about three or four moves and a half a step there.
Yes, sir, he sure does.
I really thought he might be gone. I think maybe he was looking back over his shoulder.
Well, kind of maybe looking at Jimmy Coop, wanting to see what he was going to do, and Jimmy was trying to help him out. But that got us in great field position. Cassiopo runs it down and runs hard. Cass had a real, real fine day.
And here's the Queen again.
Yes, sir, there's the Queen Bee right in the end zone. And let's not lose sight of those big guys up front, the Hogs. You know, they're knocking them off the ball.
They moved them out all afternoon, and we'll see particularly in the second half. I think after VMI was worn down, you're going to see some unbelievable holes. And here's a big play by the defense.
Big, big play. Coach Grove, they worked on that punt block all year. And I knew they'd get one before it was over.
And I believe it was Echols that got the ball, wasn't it? And then Palazzetti recovered.
Terry got there to block it. There were about four of them there. I think that Marty was the one that came up with the ball.
At this point, 35-0, and there is still a lot of time left to go in the first half.
Good play by the defense. They make them cough it up. We're back in business again.
If people think we're skipping a lot of plays, we're not. This is the way it happened in the ball game. Here goes Four Queen.
Thought he was going to score here, and I thought really he did score, but they didn't give it to him.
I'm not so sure that he didn't get his foot in, but it, in the end, didn't make any difference. You get the touchdown anyway.
Is Don Johnson getting in the end zone?
4:17 to go in the first half, 42-0. There are no records on hand as to, or no statistics on hand as to number of points and a half for Marshall, but no one that I talked to yesterday could remember 42 points and a half. That kind of dulled it a little bit, but 42-7 is not bad. And Billy Hines almost scores right here.
Billy made a great reception here, a heck of a run. Old Pops can crank it up when he needs to.
And nice to see him get a good game in front of the hometown folks.
Yes, sir, Ray.
But at halftime, 42-7, you go into the locker room. I suspect that that game was kind of fun to play, wasn't it?
Well, it was, Terry. Of course, I felt like at the half and shared it with our youngsters that if we came out the second half and just kind of went through the motions, that that would take away from what you know we had done and gotten accomplished the first half. So we felt like we had to play for a while the second half to kind of set the tone and make sure things didn't get out of hand.
Well, they did play for a while. As a matter of fact, it got even better in the second half, and we'll take a look at those highlights when we come back after this. Mm-hmm. 42-7 at halftime. I guarantee you, everybody in the press box was scurrying for the record books to try and figure out what ones were being broken, and there were... I don't know that there were any records actually broken, Coach, but an awful lot of things that haven't happened since about 1940 in terms of scoring. It didn't look like it was going to be all that great a beginning in the second half. Robert Surratt had a little trouble
well,
with
Rat
football.
Well, Surratt just had a tough time finding the handle, but the offense takes it and comes out of there with it. You can see Pops, he takes another pretty good lick and gets a first down for us.
I'll tell you, I haven't seen anybody that's gotten hit more on trying to hold the ball for kicks, too. He got run into twice in this game.
Here Timmy Lewis comes in. Brian Swisher got hurt yesterday, the peanut. Tim Lewis came in and had a big kick there. Really did.
How is Brian?
He's fine. It was an ankle injury and a sprain. I'm just glad it happened when it did, and not early in the season, because we couldn't have played without him.
Pat Velarde, one of the seniors you'll lose, kicked it too well yesterday. He kept booming it into the end zone.
Well, you know, it was real poor field position. I think he had a 38-yarder and a... You know, maybe a 37-yarder, but it wasn't his fault. That's about how close we were. And I hate like a Dickens to even make him punt, because I want him to lead the nation. And certainly he's deserving of leading the nation, but he's had an unbelievable career, and he's not through kicking yet.
And you're back on offense after the fumble recovery. That guy did something not too bright. You don't throw the ball at the official's feet.
No, you really don't. That's really a shame. You normally don't see a VMI youngster do something like that.
Well, that shows you what the frustration, I mean, you guys have been on the wrong end of some of these, too.
You do things out there you normally don't. Here's Surratt on a toss sweep. The play before that, Tim Lewis came up with another real fine catch. Here we run a toss sweep on the goal line. And, you know, I thought the Rat Man got in to score right there. I really did.
I thought he did also, and actually I thought you scored on the next play, too, but it took one more play. Carl Foder finally takes it in. And it is 49-7 at this point. And now you got to feel, well, they didn't let up
Well, this kind of set the tone for things the second half, and we let them know that we weren't going to let it get out of hand.
And here comes, I believe it's Cassiopeia.
Cassiopeia makes a real fine run up inside. Here's the Rat Man on the move again.
And watch him pick his spots. He's
so
really
good at that.
He's
really something. I tell you what, he's got a great knack for picking his spots. Dan Patterson, a real fine senior, is at quarterback now. Gets the ball to Todd Evans, and Todd wasn't going to be denied yesterday afternoon, I can promise you that.
He was running hard after he caught the ball.
He really was. A great run here by the Rat Man.
And he got bumped out there, but a little later we'll see him score one that gets called back.
Cassiopeia on the move. Look at that. You'd never think a fullback could do that. That was a great move.
I couldn't believe that one when I saw it on the highlights. He really faked him out, and then here comes the touchdown by Johnson.
Yes, sir. He walks in. We caught him in a blitz, and that's a great way to go in the end zone.
and it's 56-7, and it could have yet been worse, and we'll see in just a minute. You actually scored another time. And at this point, you've got mostly second and third team guys in
well,
here.
Well, the second liners, they played a good bit yesterday. And, you know, they needed to play and deserved to play.
I talked about the big holes you'd see.
There was a gaping hole right there that the Rat Man ran through.
And got a pass completion here, and then we'll see Surratt in just a minute again.
That's a big, big reception there by Bobby Elliman. Another split in. Played a lot of folks yesterday. Bobby came in and did a real fine job. Look at this run by the Rat Man. Yes, sir.
And that would have made it 63-7. It was called back for holding with about 4 minutes to go. Nobody put the ball in the end zone after that. How did it feel to ride off the field?
I'll tell you what, that was the greatest ride I've ever had, Terry. Believe me, it was.
I'll bet you. And I think everybody felt pretty good about the way that one ended yesterday.
Yes, sir. If they didn't, there's something wrong.
Well, what's that going to do now as far as helping the program out?
Well, of course, the big thing is, you know, being able to go out and recruit now in a little different manner than we've ever been able to recruit before. Golly Moses, you know, you go out to kids now, you haven't got to apologize or be embarrassed or anything. You say, hey, we've turned things. Look at our record, and every year we get better, and now we move to the middle of the conference standings, and next year we'd like to be able to battle and compete for the top spot, and I think our football team has come just that far. But we won't have any trouble getting the youngsters' attention. They'll be very receptive, and that's something we haven't had before. But the kids that are here now, they've made that all possible. They really have, and as I say, we've come light years in five of them, and you know, if we can continue to improve at the rate we are right now, then certainly the sky's the limit.
Well, you talk about the guys that helped turn it around. Those would be the seniors, and we'll meet those seniors when we come back after this. One of the sad things about ending any season in any sport, I guess, is that there are some folks that aren't going to come back. And in this case, I'm talking about 10 seniors, only 10 seniors on this Marshall team. We went out to the practice field earlier this week to talk to those 10 seniors and try and get a feeling for what their years at Marshall have meant to them. Take a look.
You know, I wish we could have had a better season and turn out a little better. But personally, I feel, you know, I've done my best and I'm kind of proud. Proud of myself.
I think as a team, sure, we didn't do what we wanted to do this year, but I think we laid a foundation, and I think we helped start something, and I really believe this team's going to win in the next few years.
Overall, the team, you know, we didn't do as good as I thought we would, but as far as I'm concerned, I gave it my best, and, you know, once you did your best, you know, that's personal satisfaction. You can't ask too much more than that.
It's meant to me a lot, a great deal. Met a lot of people, very nice people. They helped me out, you know, to football. That's what really got me going.
Through the 4 years I've been here, it's been a drastic change. We didn't win as many this year, but I think the public as overall can tell that we're a whole lot better team we were in the past.
I think I had a good career around here for 4 years. You know, it's been a lot of ups and down moments, you know. And I think being around here has prepared me for when I leave, you know, go out into the real world, and I think it's helped me a whole lot.
You can see improvement from what you heard and the way it's going now, and you're starting to get a little backing. It seems like it's going to change. That's the sad part about it, knowing you got to leave and they're going to win.
Being in this stage, it's easy to go into a winning program, but to go into a program like this, you feel sort of like a pioneer, you know, and I'm glad to take that role, and I'm pretty proud of what we've done over the years as far as progress that we've made.
I think, to me, it's been a good experience, and it's been a lot of rough spots I had to cover over, but if I had to do it again, I'd do it.
Well, it meant a lot playing ball here. I learned a lot. I had a good time being here. Wish I could be here another year, but you can't be here forever, so I enjoyed myself while I've been here.
There's been good times along with the bad, and we've started, you know, to turn on the program here this year, I think, and, you know, I wish I had one more year to play, because I know next year, you know, they're going to have a super team, and, you know, they're limitless next year. You know, they could go all the way, and I'd just like to be a part of it.
They threatened us with our lives if we wouldn't let them say hi, Mom, at the end.
Boy, what a great group of kids. I mean, actually young men. I always refer to them as kids, but, you know, just an unbelievable group. And they've made so much possible. And as I say, people will look back for a long time to come and said that that's the crowd that turned it right there. And then, of course, there were several that talked about next year, 17 starters coming back next year. And you can understand why they talk about wanting to be a part of it, because they know what's about to happen.
And it is interesting that at least two or three of them said, my only regret is that I'm not going to be here next year. Now, you haven't heard that in the past from a lot of people, so that should tell you what's going on, I guess.
Well, that kind of sets a tone for things, Terry. It really does. Before, they couldn't wait to get out of here. My goodness, to have to go through all of that. But these are the ones that be looked at as the ones that made it possible. Somebody's got to, get it started and rolling and headed in the right direction, and this group certainly did.
Well, let's talk about the future. Talk about next year. You don't lose very many people. We just saw 10 seniors. That's not much off an entire football squad.
No, it's not. And as I say, we've talked often. There's 17 starters that return. Quite a nucleus. There are a couple of spots that we'd like to get some help at. But if we didn't recruit anybody, we could line up and play and be a real, real good football team. But you always go out and try to help yourself. And as I say, I think we're in great shape right now as far as recruiting is concerned. We're going to get some real fine youngsters in the state, and I think we'll probably get two or three from junior college to help out in one or two areas. But other than that, we'll devote most of our time to bringing in the best freshmen we can.
Well, good luck to you. I've enjoyed the year.
It's been super. It really has. And certainly all the people that have made this show possible, we're indebted to them, because if it wasn't for them, there wouldn't be a show. So it has been great. And hopefully we can do many, many more shows together.
Okay, hope so next year. Again, as Sonny said, if it weren't for the advertisers who pay the bill, we wouldn't be here, so we appreciate them. Pay attention when we roll the credits, because the folks whose name you see there make a big difference to us. They're the ones who put the show together. Thanks to all of those folks, particularly my buddy Tom Lundy, who's pushing the buttons. Thanks for watching. I will be back next week with our first edition of the Rick Huckabee Show. We'll be talking about basketball, so join us then. And thanks for watching, everybody. For Sonny and myself, goodbye.
Today's Sonny Randle Show has been brought to you in part by Ashland Oil, where Ashland people do a good job and a little more.